गंगा जमुना सरस्वती कावेरी सरयू महेंद्र तनया क्षिप्रमती वेदिका क्षिप्रा क्षिप्रवती महासुरनदी ख्याता चंडिका पूर्णा पूर्ण जलय समुद्र सहित कुर्वन्तु मे मंगलम। आई जस्ट चांटेड द मंत्रा व्हिच इनवोक्स मेनी रिवर्स हु आर स्पिरिचुअल इन नेचर सेक्रेट रिवर्स and by invoking them they have become the symbol of a spiritual growth and learning and growing and nourishing the body, mind and soul. Himalaya indeed is a gift to the humanity, and so is Ganga and so many other rivers in India as well as in other parts of the world. Other mountains in the world are equally important. I call them the daughters of Himalaya. Many rivers in the world, they are the daughter of Ganga. Age-old tradition of learning on the bank of Ganga by sages and seers have been very important part of a spiritual evolution tradition. So those traditions, thousands of years, seers and sages, they contemplated, meditated, and after long meditation and contemplation and tapasya and research, and they gave the humanity the great knowledge.
Such a big events they take place on different at different places along the river Ganga, but who cares for the river? That's the problem. And I took this case for the protection of river Ganga in 1985. I realized that the Ganga water has become unfit for drinking, washing, bathing and irrigational purposes. It was a strange thing to me that the Ganga caught fire, and the Ganga caught fire at Haridwar. 100 meter long, the stretch caught fire. The flames were about 30 to 40 feet high.
The environment is very important. Clean air we need in the world. We need clean water. We need a clean sky. We need a clean soil, earth soil. And unfortunately, the modern so-called scientific method, modern progress, is opposite. They are ruining the soil of the earth. They are polluting the air, polluting the water, and in the sky is polluted.
God has given us such a beautiful river, and she is our mother. And when we worship on the other one hand, we worship our mother, and on the other hand we do bad things, and if by polluting the river, by throwing all garbage, all toxic things, the industrial waste, everything, it has become the Gangaji has been made as a dustbin like that, and it is shocking. We can't tolerate that. Where the aarti takes place in the evening, that is a different view and different scene, and when we can see, but down it is so bad. Taking a bath is not going to affect the pollution levels, because it is, if that is only if they swim or if they sit or if they take bath, it is a holy bath, because that Mother Ganga can tolerate that. But it cannot tolerate the toxic effluents going into the river, because the river gets choked by their industries, chemical industries, the distilleries, and there is opium factories and so many other things, the drugs. So when all those things, they go down into the river becomes polluted. We should not only talk about problem, but we should also talk about the solutions also. Because if there is no solution, what can we do? Then the river will be dead. So that is very important for us, that education.
The importance of Vedas cannot be denied. And Vedas were born in the Himalaya by great sages and seers and propounder and scholars. And when I talked of Himalaya, Himalaya is not a small place. It is thousands of miles across the east to west and north to south.
The ancient Indians, we were so respectful that the people never tried to do anything wrong.
Those who followed the Vedic path and Vedic philosophy, they were evolved and civilized and cultured high being. And how can the follower or the practitioner would be primitive? Couldn't be primitive. Only such a profound thought has to come from profoundness of mind.
The education, when we talk about Vedas, then in Vedas everything is there. What is lacking in there? Is these are perfect things which teach everything, and to the how we have to respect the nature, what we can do, what has to be done, and then not only that, how our we can evolve our soul.
And science can be integrated with the Vedic philosophy. And once it is integrated with the Vedic philosophy, science and technology, then it can create a wonder. Then we can have the best of the both world.
We have to become conscious for that, and that consciousness can come only by creating a model of education.
If the society can run by the Vedic principle, then society can become, or community, or the world village can become paradise on earth.
It is not the one day work. It is a constant effort. So, and constant effort can only be possible when the institutions some awareness programs. We have done that. But it is just a one drop in the sea. But a drop can definitely make a difference. If we unite all the drops, this becomes the river. This becomes the ocean. So what we are doing? So we have to now, it is a collective effort of the people. This river belongs to the whole world, not to India alone now.